Now, next page, it says issuance of bonds example. And we're going to go through this example. Face value of the bonds, $1 million. Term, 5 year versus what? Term versus serial bond, which matures in installments. Stated interest rate, 8%. That's how much cash I'm going to get. I'm going to get 8% of $1 million or $80,000 in cash. But what am I earning? That's a different question. Then it says effective or market or yield is 8 in example A, 10 in example B, 6 in example C. So notice that we're going to be doing three examples. One is going to be 8-8, which is issued at par, issued at face. We don't have to worry about the discount or premium. Then we'll go to a discount example. Then we'll go to a premium example. And then life will be beautiful for you. Things will make sense. Okay, so we've got 8, 10, and 6. Let's do that. So this is going to be example A, B, and C. All right. So what do we have? 5 year term bond, $1 million face value, 8% stated rate. You're going to be paying me interest of 80,000. And then we have par, discount, premium. All right, so let's go through our example A. Now, in the first case, I'm going to issue the bond. Now, in this case, it's real easy. There's no bond issue cost. There's no accrued interest. There's nothing like that. But we'll throw that in later to get even uglier. So we start out credit bonds payable, always for face, $1 million. I'm going to leave a few zeros off to save time. Now, because there's no discount or premium, we're going to issue it for face, par, $1 million. Okay. Now, what's going to happen every year? Every year, you're going to pay me 8% of $1 million. I'm going to get some sort of cash. Okay? So I'm going to debit cash. Now, this is the guy that issued the bond. So let's start over. Here's the bond issuer. So the person issuing the bond is going to do what? He's going to credit cash for 80 and debit interest expense for 80. So notice it's costing him 8% of $1 million or 80 grand. He's going to pay out that much cash. So as far as the investor side, what is the investor doing? The investor is debiting cash and crediting interest income, just the opposite, debit cash. So the person buying this has an investment in bonds and a credit to cash. They have an investment in bonds, credit to cash. Then they're going to have cash and interest income. And I believe in the notes I said, bonds issued at par where market rate is 8% is debit cash, credit bonds payable. Each year, interest expense, credit cash. Okay? But the person buying it, the investor. Now, just so you know, this section is going to mainly focus on the issuer because it gets more ugly. However, we did mention investment in bonds. Remember, debt or equity. We have trading available held to maturity or bonds you intend to hold till the, you know, and what do you keep them at? Amortized cost, which would be your face net of unamortized discount or premium. We mentioned that back in the marketable security section and the investment section. Just to kind of keep it in mind, and at the time I said bonds are a little tricky. We'll talk about those later. Guess what? Now is later. Hey, it's about time. All right. The second situation in B, this would be a discount. Now, in this case, they're going to credit bonds payable always for face, so $1 million. Now, how much cash are they getting? Because you want to earn more than 8%, I'm going to charge you less than 8%, so I'm going to only get $900,000 up front. The difference is going to be the discount. And let's say in this case it's 100. Now, to keep it simple, I'm going to amortize the discount one of two ways, straight line, not gap, or effective interest method, gap. And that's going to use the same effective interest table that you were introduced to in notes receivable in an earlier section. However, we're going to go into it in more detail because in that example, there was no cash being paid every year, just not until the note was matured. Now we're going to go through and have cash every year changing hands. Now, to keep it simple, it's a 5 year bond, that's 20 bucks a year. So, what are we going to do? They're going to pay out cash of 80 bucks. They're paying the same amount, cash, 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 because it's 8% of $1 million. That is based on the stated face nominal coupon rate. We're also going to amortize out the discount. Now, in amortizing out the discount, we're just going to amortize it straight line. So this is going to be credit amortization of discount, taking out 20. What is your plug? Interest expense. Notice it's going to be 100. So to keep it simple, remember, this is 8%. That's how much cash, right? Here, cash, 8%. But remember, at a discount, you wanted to earn 10%. I can't just erase the bond and make it from 8 to 10, so I'm paying you 10% in cash. Instead, I charge you less upfront. And what's going to be happening now is, here's the cash at 8%, here's your interest expense, it's really costing me what? 10%. Okay. The person who bought the bond would what? They would debit cash for 80, they would take out their discount on their investment, and they would have interest income of 100. So as we look at this, you'll see that this 1,000 net of 100 is what? 900. That was called our carrying amount or our amortized cost. And then every year, what happens? We're going to amortize out of the 100. We're going to come out 20, 20, 20, 20. So the carrying value goes 900, 920, 940, 960, 980, up to 1,000. This goes to zero. Get rid of the bond payable for 1,000, credit cash for 1,000. We're done. So do you see how we're amortizing it out? But by amortizing the discount or premium, it affects your interest expense and from the investor side, the interest income. So the person who purchased it would affect their interest income or income, and the issuer would affect their interest expense. Now, the other thing that I want to kind of mention here, and this is for those that are a little more advanced, maybe you've taken the exam, didn't pass it, or you've already done a lot of studying and this stuff will make sense. With our statement of cash flows, let's think about it. How much cash did we pay out? You paid out 80. But how much is on our income statement as expense? You have interest expense of 100. So on your statement of cash flows, you're going to think you paid out 100, but you really only paid out 80, which means don't I still have 20 grand in my pocket? Yeah. So on a statement of cash flows, you add back a discount. You add back a discount, but you take out a premium. You'll see that in a minute. So that's what's happening in this case. Let's now go on to example C, which would be a premium. That means that you're paying me 8%, but I only want you to earn 6%. So we start out credit bonds payable for $1 million. We're going to debit cash. I'm going to charge you $1,000,001 up front. The difference is called a premium for 100. Notice, what's the carrying value? What is the amortized cost of the bonds? It's $1,000,001. What does it have to go down to? It has to go down to $1 million. In a discount, what happens? It starts at 900 and it's got to go up, up, up to $1 million. So notice in a discount, it starts small and gets bigger. In a premium, it starts big, $1,000,001, and gets smaller. So that's the issuance. Then what are we going to do? We're going to pay out cash every year of 80. We're going to take the premium, we'll do it straight line just to keep it simple. 100 over 5 is 20. So we will take out amortization of premium for 20. What is your plug? Interest expense. So notice interest expense is the plug for 60. I'm paying you cash of 8, but you're really only earning 6. That's how you play with the interest rate. So I want you to earn less, I'm going to charge you more up front. I want you to earn more, I'll charge you less up front. That's why if the stated rate, which is 8%, the stated rate is less than the effective rate, that's a discount. If the stated rate is, in this case, 8%, is greater than the effective rate, then we're going to have a premium. So that's what's happening as far as the amounts and as far as the amortization. Now, same thing here on a statement of cash flows. What is the difference? On a statement of cash flows, here my expense is 60, but it really costs me 80, so I have less cash, back out the premium. So add back the discount, back out the premium. Add back the discount, back out the premium. It'll make more sense after we cover cash flows, which we're going to cover in about in a little while. Okay. The reason I cover cash flows towards the end, it involves so many transactions that you may not be familiar with because it deals with assets, liabilities, equity. We haven't talked about stockholders' equity, so I don't want to talk about how to manipulate those journal entries until we've learned them. Makes sense. Sure. Okay. So that's what's happening. Again, I want you to understand the concept about issued at par or face value versus a discount versus a premium.